CNBC-TV18 Weekender, only on CNBC-TV18.
Hello and welcome to The Weekender at CNBC-TV18. I'm Manisha Gupta. Well, India is the second largest producer of tea in the world, and 70% of what we produce, India consumes in itself. This year, of course, has been quite positive because India has seen all-time high production and record high exports as well. So clearly, it is tea that we are talking about. And joining us on The Weekender is Karan Shah. He is the fourth generation at Society Tea in the family business. Karan also has done business administration with international marketing at Kent University. Karan also holds a degree in the music production from SAE London. Thank you so much, Karan, for joining us for this Weekender. And what an year it has been for tea as an industry, especially for Indian markets, where you have seen an all-time high production, all-time high exports as well. What really has led to that?
I believe the government's helped the smaller producers. These are people with 5 hectares, 7 hectares of land. So this is the kind of tea that's called bought leaf. So they've aided these producers, so to say, to go and sell their produce, however small it may be, to larger gardens. So that's kind of raised the quantum quite a bit. Mm. The fact is that the leaf deteriorates as soon as it's plucked out. So it's very essential that the processing is done immediately after, or as soon as it can be. Okay. And the government really aided the facilitation of this process.
So would you say that much of this quantum really has come in from the smaller producers and not from the large companies perhaps?
I think the overall number could have been very well affected by the fact that these bought leaf numbers are added to the spectrum.
All right. So Karan, when you say that, are you saying that all perhaps the government's reforms or strategies have worked well for the tea industry in India?
I believe so. Yes, it has. It has. I think the fact that the smaller producers getting the incentives and the help from the government, The percentage increase could have possibly come from there as well. Mm. And the fact that it's been a good crop. Mm.
You know, for the longest time, it wasn't a lot of... I remember tea industries coming out and saying that the remunerations perhaps have been low. The cost of production has been on the higher side. But we have seen that improving as well. So would you say that achhe din for tea industry are finally here?
Well, I believe it's not the worst of times.
Okay.
But I'm sure it could. I'm sure we can see better days as well. I don't want to say that we're one of those people that will settle ourselves and be happy where we are.
All right.
I think we can do better. I think we can do better as an industry. And I think it's looking quite rosy from the way up.
It is, yes. Tell us more about Society Tea to begin with.
Sure.
I mean, you've been an industry, or you've been a name that has been around for the longest time.
We have, yes.
Tell us when it began, where it began, all and right, who actually started it.
Okay. So it was my great-grandfather that started it. I'm the fourth generation, along with my brothers. Mm. We're actually almost 100 years into the tea business. Hasmukhra & Company was formed in 1933 when we started the retail tea trade, which is where you'd go to a shop and you tailor make a cup of tea, which is, according to me, the best way to do it. And I see that coming back majorly. But this is when the consumer knew what exactly they wanted. They'd go to a store and they'll tailor make a blend based on their preferences. And that was the trend of purchase. Mm. I think that changed, so to say, in 27 years ago when Society Tea was born. The consumer wanted a different shopping experience. They wanted to go to a show and they wanted to feel that retail experience where they'll trust a brand to give them that quality and decide for themselves.
So why the name Society Tea then? What brought about that branding?
It was just a panel discussion that brought them. There's no interesting story. I'll be making it up.
Well, try me on that. But, you know, also tell us about how the industry itself has changed, because tea, when it started, really was in a loose form. I believe that is how it goes around in some parts of India.
Yes,
but there are some areas which really go for the branded and speciality teas.
True. In fact, that was the time when Society Tea was born as well, which is 27 years ago, when people wanted a shopping experience. So they'd like to go to a place and kind of experience the brand selecting a particular quality for them. And I think that's prevalent, except for the fact that now you have the online advent as well.
Yes.
So that's the one major change that's happened after Society's inception. But yes.
So, you know, historically and culturally, while tea is much deep-rooted in India as in sense of culture there, would you also say that, you know, as we've gone past the year, the tea industry is quite technologically evolved now? What really is the technology that you look at, the automation? Because that really seems to be changing the face of each industry. How is tea looking into that?
I think that's a very good question. And I think I am very happy to say that us as a company, we're taking on automation very seriously. Mm. Also with the advent of the changes in FSSAI, health, we're looking at, we're very conscious as a country now. India is very quick to change, I believe. You know, we at one stage, we don't look at quality at all. We always have, but and all of a sudden we'll be all on the bandwagon of making sure that the consumer gets a very, very, very conscious cup. Mm. We're looking at automation very seriously. We're looking at quality control very seriously. In fact, our new production plant is possibly one of the best in the country as of now. I would like to talk to you about it.
Sure, tell us about it. So where is it coming up and what are you looking forward to?
I can't mention that just yet because it's not ready, but it's 6 months down the line that we'll have a state-of-the-art plant with heavy automation than most people have at this stage.
So how will that change society tea from where it is now to that?
No, it just means that society tea will be produced at a lot more efficient rate than it is right now. Mm. We're doing a lot of overtimes. That will stop. Mm. We can now get society to a lot more states, so a lot more people will be able to enjoy the quality that we bring to Maharashtra and the other states as of now.
Mm. You know, tell us also about what the Indian preferences are right now. Is India still, as we like to call it, a very price-sensitive country, or are people paying a premium or willing to pay a premium if they get better quality?
We as a consumer, we are so complicated. We would pay a premium. I think the fact is that as time has progressed, the generation, the millennials, have been known to pay a certain price more than their predecessors for quality. Mm. But when it comes to tea, I think it's a little tricky. You know, no matter how much you spend on a meal, you'll still be very conscious about the cup of tea that you purchase.
You know, also for the longest time, it has been about the mom and dad, middle-aged perhaps, yes, or middle-class kind of a drink because there was so, yes, much other available. But, yes, now do you see it changing a lot
because the
younger population...
on the fact that it changes very much so. Right. We have a lot of time and effort invested into tomorrow's consumer. We have a beautiful iced tea coming out in the market. There's the instant iced teas that are completely in the market as we speak now. Mm. But also our instant teas. So what we've done is we've gone and... We set up a plant to get in. So we're manufacturing dairy. Mm. So we're processing milk to get dairy whiteners. We're doing excellent ghee, by the way. Mm. This is all because that we're doing this instant tea, and dairy constitutes a large set of the mix. And it actually, by the end, it decides on how the cup will be. Mm. We're also producing our own instant teas. So everything is in-house. It's a turnkey project. And we control how your final cup is. And all of this was backtracked from my grandmom's cup of tea at home. So we've sat and we've taken a list of all the ingredients she puts in. And we've tried to make it as efficient as possible.
So when it comes to tea preferences or choices, as, right, we were talking earlier, yes, for Maharashtra drinks, it's tea very different,
yes,
to what
does.
Delhi does, to what
it
Gujarat
does
perhaps. Does. So are you catering to all of those markets?
As a stereotype, I'd say Maharashtra loves this ginger tea. With a bit of lemongrass. Gujaratis, we love it all. So we blend every known spice there is. But we do it right. I quite like it.
Masala tea.
Masala,
yeah,
tea is what we're,
right,
talking about. The north likes its elaichi. Possibly because of the region. Possibly because of the temperature. As you go up north, it changes. There's a lot of saffron involved. But that's also, if I can say, this is one of the reasons where we're celebrating the Tea Society, that's India. You know, the new campaign is called For the Tea Society Called India.
And it has caught quite an eyeball. I mean, eyeballs. I was actually coming to that in my next question. What really led to that campaign? And
so,
it's done well and
it's got
you some awards there.
Yeah, fifth award, and I believe there's two more on the way. So we're quite
congratulations,
excited. Thank,
yeah,
you so much. Thank
so,
you.
You know, how important is campaigning, marketing, advertising, taking it out to the consumers in that sense. What really led to that? And is it a revenue generation at the end of it?
So, obviously not taking away from the fact that quality consciousness is the most important thing. That's not enough, in my eyes, to win you a place or a helm at the top. Marketing is very important. Communication is very important. So the consumer deserves to know how the company thinks. You know, the consumer deserves to be treated as the most important thing there is. And I believe communication and marketing are the only ways where you can kind of communicate your values, your ethos over to them. And it shares a place right on top with quality. So marketing and quality go hand in hand. It's a blend, I think. It's a blend of both.
So, well, of course, you are celebrating your campaign right now. But give me in a pecking order on how would you put it? Is it letting the competition know that you're in the market? Is it also about creating awareness? Is it sensitizing your consumers out there? Or is it clearly about telling them on how different you are from others?
So it's a two-part campaign. We've sent out a video team for 6 months across the country to shoot these beautiful nuances that celebrate tea drinking. They're very, very, we're romanticizing everyday tea drinking, if I can say so myself. We've done the same with our photography team. We've sent out a couple of photographers, very revered photographers, if I may add, through the length and breadth of the country to capture these moments. And it's a photo essay. This isn't a print campaign for us. It's a photo essay. It's a labor of love. We've put in our heart and soul into it. And
each picture tells its own stories.
It does.
All right, Karan, hold that thought. With that, we will take a short tea break, come back and resume our conversation on a cup of tea.
CNBC-TV18 Weekender, only on CNBC-TV18.